Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to talk about things that I do not buy anymore as a minimalist. Last week I did a video about 8 things that I do buy more of ever since becoming more minimal. So if you missed that, I will link it up here and down below for you guys if you want to check that out after this video. But today I'm going to share with you 30 different things that I do not buy anymore. Before we get started, if you are new, welcome. I make videos all about minimalism, simple living, and decluttering. So if that sounds interesting to you, hit that subscribe button down below so we can hang out every single week. So the first thing I don't buy anymore is fast fashion. So when I was in high school, middle school, practically all up until maybe around college, I used to buy a lot of fast fashion. So my favorite stores used to be Forever 21, Charlotte Russe, H&M, all those stores like that. That's where I used to buy all of my clothes from. Ever since becoming more minimalist, I also started learning more about being eco-friendly and sustainable, and I learned that fast fashion is just such a horrible industry, and the way that they treat their workers and everything like that is just not something that I support, so I no longer buy fast fashion anymore. Work clothing. So I don't buy specific work clothing anymore. I used to buy long sleeve blouses, blazers, the black slack pants, fancy shoes, and now I don't really need that anymore, so I stopped buying work clothes. But what I do now is that whatever I buy, I try to keep in mind if I can wear it on a casual day or if it's also appropriate for work and the office. So everything that I do own, like for example this top, is something that's pretty casual but I also can wear to work. It's not too casual but it's not too dressed up, so I really like this because I can wear it, like I said, casual or dress it up and wear it to the office and work. So when I do buy clothing now, I do try to keep that in mind. I need to be able to wear it on a casual day or a regular work day. Jewelry. So I also used to buy a lot of jewelry back in the day. Again, also from Forever 21. I think that's where most of my jewelry came from. That's, you know, pretty cheap jewelry, and that jewelry is the type of jewelry that kind of goes bad. It leaves your fingers green if you're wearing rings, and necklaces start to fade and rust. Although it is fairly cheap, it's not going to last you a really long time, so I stopped also purchasing jewelry like that as well. Now when I do want to treat myself to some nice fancy jewelry, I do buy high quality jewelry now that's not going to wear away in just a few months. Next, I stopped buying cleaning supplies. So I still have a few cleaning supplies that I'm still using. I'm trying to use those up, but I'm also switching over now to making my own DIY cleaners. So if you're interested in seeing in a video about that where I talk about the DIY cleaners that I use, let me know down below because I'd love to share that with you guys. But basically I use things like vinegar, dish soap, essential oils, things like that to make my own DIY cleaners. And it's also much better to do DIY cleaners because the other stuff that you buy from the stores has a lot of chemicals in it, so I'm really trying to reduce all that in my home, so I make my own cleaners now. I've also stopped purchasing single-use items. Again, I still have some of these paper plates and cups and things like that, but I don't go out and purchase them anymore. I am trying to use them up because I just don't want to have them around anymore, but I don't buy those things anymore. I don't buy wipes or plastic straws, things that are single use. I also don't buy poor quality items anymore. Before, back in the day, I used to kind of just get whatever was the cheapest because I was being cheap. And I was like, I don't care about the quality, as long as it's cheap, I'm going to buy it. But now my mindset is like totally different now. I will not buy poor quality items, whether it's clothing, appliances, electronics. I try to get the best quality items, even though it is going to be a little bit more pricey, it's going to be worth it in the long run. I also try to not buy duplicate items. Again, this just goes with about everything. I try to make sure that I don't have multiples of the same item because usually if I do have that, I gravitate towards one more. Like for example, if I have 2 spatulas, there's probably just one spatula that I use more than the other one. So there's no point in having duplicate items like that if you're just going to be using that one that you always love and use. I realize that having duplicates of certain items is not necessary because I'm not going to be using all of them. I usually just use one so I don't buy duplicates anymore. I also don't buy brand new books. So in my last video that I posted last week about things that I do buy, I did mention that I do buy books, but I don't buy brand new books. I buy used books. Let's say I checked out a book from the library and I really like that book. Obviously, I have to return that one, but if I really liked it, then I will go out and see if I can find a used version of it. I just don't buy brand new books anymore. First of all, they're going to be a lot more pricey than if you find it used somewhere. So I don't buy brand new books anymore. I also stopped buying coffee. I was never a person that went out to a Starbucks every single day. Like, I know some people do that, which is just mind-blowing. Like, I could never go spend $5 every day for a coffee. So basically now what I do is if I want coffee, I just make it at home now. I have a Keurig that I use. I'll put the coffee grounds in a reusable K-cup, and that's how I make my coffee at home. Otherwise, if I'm at work, I still go to the office. After being working from home for a few months, I am now back at the office, so the office has another Keurig there, and I make my coffee there as well. So there's really no point in going out and buying coffee anymore from like a Starbucks or a shop or anything like that. So I don't buy coffee anymore. Eyeshadow is something else that I don't buy anymore. I used to buy a bunch of palettes because it was something that my favorite YouTuber used to buy, and I would go out and purchase it because I thought I needed it. And then I came to the realization that I'm like, wow, this is a lot of eyeshadow and I don't even wear that much eyeshadow, so why am I purchasing these items? So now I do have a couple of eyeshadow palettes, and my goal is trying to just use them up as best as I can. It's probably gonna take me like 10 years, but it's definitely something that I don't purchase anymore because I don't find the need to wear that much eyeshadow. I'm not even that good at makeup, so I don't even know why I used to buy so much eyeshadow and makeup palettes and things like that. Blush, I used to again buy blush for whatever reason, and honestly, I've always hated blush. So I don't know why I used to buy blush all the time, but I finally stopped. But this was like years ago, way before even becoming a minimalist. I was like, why am I even buying blush? I hate wearing it. I feel like I already have like a natural blush because my cheeks get like pink and red sometimes really easily. So I'm just like, I don't need to buy blush. I naturally blush, so I stopped buying that. I also stopped buying plastic water bottles, and this one I've done for a couple of years now, and it's just obviously so much better for the environment. It's eco-friendly, and now I just use reusable water bottles. I have a water filter at home, so I don't buy plastic water bottles anymore. And if I do go somewhere where I need to have water, then I'll just bring my reusable water bottle with me. But I never purchase plastic water bottles anymore, and I honestly like it that way. Not only is it better for the environment, but I'm also saving money. I used to buy a lot of magazine subscriptions back in the day, and I remember being excited that I would have new magazines coming in the mail, and I really only cared about who was like on the cover of that month and basically everything else in the magazine. I didn't actually read through it. Not really sure exactly why I used to get magazine subscriptions, but I just remember not even finishing a magazine. I would have it and I would flip through a few pages and then I just put it aside and never pick it up again. And the next thing I know, the next month is around and the next issue is in the mail. I'm like, wait, I haven't even gone through this one yet and I already have the new one. So I found that I just didn't really need to have magazines anymore. I hardly ever looked at them and I basically never finished them. So I ended up canceling my magazine subscriptions. I also don't buy plastic shower curtains anymore. I used to just always buy that all the time, and the only reason why I did that was because I didn't know that there were shower curtains that were not made out of plastic. I know it sounds kind of dumb, but I honestly didn't know that there were not plastic shower curtains available, so I would just always buy plastic curtains, and obviously it's so much better than buying plastic, so I don't use the plastic shower curtains anymore. So about a year ago, I did a huge closet declutter and I got rid of a ton of plastic hangers and I bought some velvet hangers, and honestly, my life completely changed. Velvet hangers, Highly recommend them. I will leave the ones that I use linked down below if you want to check them out. I'll also leave anything else that I'm mentioning in this video that I use linked down below. But ever since using velvet hangers, my life has just been so much easier. The plastic hangers are really annoying to deal with. My shirts will fall off and I'd find them on the floor, and then it was just a hassle. And then finally I was like, you know, I'm sick of these plastic hangers. I'm going to buy velvet hangers, and I love it. It's one of the best purchases that I've made. I also don't buy plastic containers anymore, like food containers. I don't buy that anymore. I do have some that I currently use, but that's because I don't want to go out and purchase brand new ones because I'm still using those. But if I were to need containers, then I would definitely buy glass ones instead of plastic. I no longer buy Ziploc bags anymore. I used to buy them for my snacks. I used to put them in there for my lunches and things like that. And I just don't buy Ziploc bags anymore. I haven't for quite some time now. Besides using Ziploc bags, you can use things like stashers. Stashers are reusable and basically the same thing as a Ziploc bag, except that it's not plastic and you can use it over and over and over again. So those are great, and I highly recommend you checking those out if you want to cut back on your Ziploc plastic bag usage. Seasonal decor. So this one is still taking me some time to get used to because I just absolutely love decor, but I always think about how, like, when I'm at the store and I'll see something that I like, I'll think about where can I put this in my home, and usually there's never any space. So that's really helped me trying to limit my purchasing of home decor items or seasonal decor items. But it's something that's really hard because till this day I go to the store and I'm just like, it's so cute, I want it, it's perfect for summer or fall or whatever season it may be, and I'm just like, ugh. And if there is something that I really want to get, then I'll use my one in, one out policy where I will get rid of something that's in my house so I can bring this new piece in. Dryer sheets. So dryer sheets are pointless. I don't know what else to say about them. I used to buy them, not all the time, but I did used to buy them, and then I just completely stopped. There hasn't been a significant change in my laundry. So I don't know, I don't see a point in using dryer sheets, so I stopped doing that a long time ago. Another hard one for me is knickknacks, but I don't buy knickknacks anymore. Especially when I go thrifting, I like to go into the knickknack section. I like to see everything that's sitting there and I'm just like, oh, I really love this, this is really cute, I would love to put this in my house. But again, I try to visualize and I'm like, where can I put this? Do I have room for this? And the answer is almost always no. So I don't buy knickknacks anymore. I used to buy them all the time as well, but it's just something that just doesn't fit in my home, so I don't buy them anymore. Similarly with knickknacks, I also don't buy souvenir items anymore. I do have a couple of souvenir items from past trips that I've gone on with family and friends. I recently, in my last trip that I went to Portland earlier this year, I didn't buy any souvenir items. I just found that it's not really necessary, and if there's something that I do really like, I can just take a picture of it and have a digital photo of it rather than the actual item. But again, I was just like, I don't really need to have souvenir items. It's all in my head, all these memories, and I don't need a souvenir item to tell me that I went to Portland or whatever. I also stopped buying air fresheners for my home and my car. I used to buy both of them a lot, and although they do smell nice and everything, it's just something that I didn't want to keep up with because, you know, they run out, they have to go buy a new one and just repeat over and over again. And I just kind of got tired of doing that. Although it does smell very nice, I just didn't see a point in doing that. For my car, if I want my car to smell fresh or anything, I just roll down the windows. And in my home, instead of using air fresheners, I do that as well. I just open the windows, let some air in. And when I do want to freshen up my home a little bit, I do turn on my candles. I also stopped buying gym memberships a while ago. I used to go to the gym all the time, and although it was relatively inexpensive, the gym membership that I had, I just found it was too much of a hassle to get up early or go after work and go to the gym, work out, drive back home, and I just found also that I wasn't seeing great results. Like, I love going to the gym, I love that environment, and it was really good for my mental health. But I did want to cut back on some expenses, so I completely canceled it for that reason. And then I started doing workouts at home. So before this whole pandemic, I was already doing workouts from home. I was doing DVD workouts, YouTube workouts mainly, and honestly, this whole gym shutting down thing never really affected me because I stopped going to the gym a long time ago. And honestly, I have seen better results working out from home and doing my own thing rather than when I was going to the gym 5-6 days a week. So that's kind of weird. That's how it works out for me. And I don't think I'll ever be needing to purchase a gym membership again, just because the things that I'm doing at home with my home workouts have been really effective, and I don't see myself needing to go to the gym anymore. I also stopped buying makeup wipes a long time ago, and that was just also another big change that I made that has saved me not only a lot of money, but I started to use reusable cloths to remove my makeup, and it's just worked out the same way. There's no big difference. I'm not missing wipes because they were better or anything. The cloth works just as great as well. If you're interested in the ones that I use, I will leave links down below for you guys. But after using the cloths now, that's all I use now, and honestly, it works just as well as the makeup wipe remover. So if you're still buying them, please try to not buy them anymore. Use reusable cotton pads or the cloth that I use. It's so much better, and it's also going to save you a lot of money. I have stopped buying soda. I can't even remember the last time I bought or drank soda. It's been over maybe 2 years. Mainly the reason why I cut soda out of my diet and just purchasing it altogether was because I wanted to save calories, and I feel like I would rather eat my calories than drink my calories, so I completely stopped buying soda for that pure reason. I don't miss it at all. Like, with everything, you get used to it, and I prefer it that way. There are no times where I'm craving soda anymore. It's just been so long that my body doesn't even think about it or crave it anymore. So completely cutting out soda has been very beneficial for me, not only in my health, but also, again, saving money that way too. I also stopped buying apps. I used to buy a lot of apps back in the day, whether they were for playing games or some Photoshop thing or to make my selfies look better or something like that. I used to buy apps like that, and I do not buy apps like that anymore. Either I just don't have a need for them anymore, or I just don't feel like it's worth the investment. Usually just get by using a free trial or the free version of the app if I need to use it. I also stopped buying DVDs and CDs. I mean, obviously CDs, like, they're not a thing anymore. My car doesn't even play CDs anymore, so I obviously don't buy those. But DVDs, I used to buy DVDs all the time. I used to love having all these movies and have a collection of them, but I just find that I don't need DVDs anymore. If I want to watch a movie or anything, I can just find it online or on Netflix, so I completely stopped purchasing DVDs. I also stopped buying pre-made meals or those convenient meals where you just go, for example, at a convenience store or an airport. You have all those places that have food and they're all packaged for you. But I completely stopped buying those a long time ago. It's just also very expensive, and it's going to be a lot cheaper if I just prepare a meal for myself using ingredients that I buy from the store. So I no longer buy those pre-cut vegetables and fruit and things like that, because it's going to be a lot better if I just make it on my own. I also don't buy plastic utensils anymore. I used to buy plastic spoons and forks. I never really understood why I did that, but I think I was just lazy. I didn't want to wash the dishes, so I don't buy them anymore. I also don't upgrade my technology anymore. I have the iPhone 6s now, and it's really old, but it does everything that I need it to do, so I don't really need to upgrade it at all. If I had to upgrade my technology, let's say for example if my camera broke down, I obviously need it to make YouTube videos, so then I would buy a new one. But as far as upgrading my technology, I don't really go out and purchase or really care about the latest technology out there. Before, I used to care, but now I don't even keep up with trends anymore or care about the latest upgrade on something that I already have. So those are all the 30 things that I do not buy anymore after becoming a minimalist. So let me know down in the comments below if you can relate to any of these, or let me know what you stopped buying after becoming more minimal. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a thumbs up. It supports me and my channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.